Flying in space is one thing, but most of us really can't relate to rocket ships or space capsules.
Yeah, helicopters, on the other hand, are a regular sight in the sky over Des Moines. Air ambulances like Mercy One are out there day and night. And for even the most experienced helicopter pilot, night flying has its own challenges.
Our own chopper pilot, John McLaughlin, recently went up with the folks on Mercy One. And tonight he shows us the two critical steps they've taken to increase safety.
Hi, everybody. Meteorologist John McLaughlin on the helipad at Mercy Hospital to talk about some improvements in the program here. Number one, the ability to fly instrument approaches directly into remote helipads, and the addition of night vision goggles, which turn the night into day.
Darkness and bad weather are enemies of helicopter medical operations. That's why the nation's leading helicopter services are making the transition to night vision goggles, NVG for short. The NVGs amplify light outside the cockpit, turning the blackness into an eerie green. But they have a narrow field of view, so you must scan left, right, up and down to maintain awareness. It's now possible to see hazards like unlit towers, power lines, and uneven terrain that could turn night flights into a disaster.
Stewart area, mass traffic, lifeguard helicopter 1, echo Delta Atlantic at the Stewart LZ.
But you still have to fly the helicopter, and that's done by peeking underneath the goggles to reference flight instruments and engine health monitors. Imagine trying to drive your car while looking through binoculars. It's a balancing act and takes hours to perfect. But the world of NVG makes the previously impractical a reality.
When we're out looking for, we're helping an agency do a search, it drastically improves our odds of finding what we're looking for.
Mercy's Bell 429 uses Garmin GPS technology, much like you may have in your car, but with a more precise lateral and vertical navigation called WAS to safely follow a glide path to remote helipads like this one near I-80 at Stewart. In other words, Mercy pilots don't need an airport to operate when the clouds are low or the visibility is restricted.
Before, we wouldn't be able to call the helicopter. Now we can, which is something that helps us out quite a bit.
After landing in Stewart during our test flight, local emergency workers got a chance to peek through these $12,000 goggles and get a better understanding of how NVGs work.
It's quite impressive.
It's a tremendous benefit for us, especially out here in a rural setting. The closest hospital for us is 21 miles. The major trauma centers are 39. In the events of bad weather, where it's borderline weather, the ship, or Mercy One, has capabilities of getting out here.
No helicopter flight is without risk, but Mercy is demonstrating that managing the hazards of weather and off-airport operations with an instrument-equipped aircraft and a crew not just trained for flight in the clouds and darkness, but doing it routinely makes good safety sense.
And I would like a pair of those goggles if we can get that arranged. Methodist Hospital also using night vision goggles in their new EC-145 aircraft, and they're also working toward that GPS WAS approach certification so they can fly into those remote helipads.
Neat pictures, neat experience, I'm sure.
Stuff there.
Yeah. Would tonight be a good practice night?
It's dark, it's kind of gloomy, rainy, perfect for night vision and instrument weather. Back with your forecast.